Now the last of the five dynamic objects, we've looked at XY plot, trend, bar graph, value, etc. The last one is something we call a multi-state symbol. And let me just demonstrate this very simply. I'm going to create a little circle here, and that circle I would like to change color every time this value goes above, say, 80 and below 20. The way to do that is by looking at this, or selecting that object, and then choosing this option over here called multi-state symbol. Now you can also choose edit from the edit menu, the option called multi-state. That's not under the draw menu, that's under the edit menu. Either way, when you either choose that edit multi-state or choose this little icon here, what you're presented with is a dialog box in which you can specify the tag whose value will determine what the whose value is going to determine what color this is. Now, in this case, I've selected an object that is not associated with any other tag. So it seems pretty obvious that I can choose anything I want, right? Well, interesting thing to mention, if you choose one of these other things, like for example, let's look at this this value right here, or this bar graph. If you choose one of these, you can also make that into a multi-state, and in that case, you can also choose whichever tag you want. You don't have to have the value or the color of this value determined by the value of that tag. It can be for any tag. So that's the first point to make, is you can choose any tag that will be the trigger for this multi-state. Now I'll go ahead and choose this again. And for the tag, well, I'll use that one I used for so many other things. We'll take a look at that tag called sinusoid. We'll say when it goes below, or when it goes above 80, we'll see a specific value, below 20, a different value. Now I've selected that as sinusoid. We've retrieved it, and we've also retrieved some information about this tag. We know, for example, it goes from 0 to 100. That's the range. Now by default, it divides this into three or two states, but you can control this to make this as many states as you want. Okay. I'm going to choose three. And for state one, I would like that. That's the least state here, the smallest number. I want this to extend from 0 to 20. And you'll notice all these things adjust as we do this. We see the preview. For state three, or excuse me, for state two, I'd like to go from 20 to 80. And then this adjusts appropriately for state three. State three, as you can see, automatically adjusts from 80 to 100. Now what I didn't do yet is specify the colors. For the color, this is how I can specify it. Let's say this is going to be, we'll go with green for low, for the center color, state 2. We'll go with, let's just go with blue. And for the high color, we'll go with red. There we go. So once I've done that, I'll go ahead and say OK. And at this point, now I can demonstrate this behavior by scrolling back and forth. As you can see, when it goes below 20, the value here goes green. When it goes above 20, it goes to blue. Above 80, it goes to red. Yeah. So that's our multi-state. We could have done exactly the same thing over here to this value here. I could have specified the same type of multi-state, in which case we would see, let me go ahead and make this bolder so it's easier to see, in which case we can base it on the tag itself or on a different tag if we choose. So we'll do three states, 0 to 20, 20 to 80, and then we'll set the colors. Color for this, let's go with the green, blue, and red. So now we should see these track each other. Yes, that when this turns blue, and vice versa, turns green, etc. So just about any object can be a multi-state except a trend itself, a graphic that you've imported. We can't change the buttons. Also, any Ole objects cannot change their color. But just about anything else can. If you noticed on our previous demo, we saw on that main column bottom display, there were a number of bar graphs that were changing colors. And that's how we did it with a multi-state. Now there's a couple of options that we've ignored so far. Let's go back into the multi-state definition. I'll select this, because this is where I believe it makes most sense. we would like to specify a color for bad data. So in other words, if this value of this tag is unavailable, we would like that color to be or to show up. So for example, I'll go with a dull gray. And a way to demonstrate this would be to scroll off into the future. As you can see, when I scroll off into the future, there's essentially no data here. And notice how nice this is. It's kind of grayed out. So it gives us a nice indicator visually that there's something wrong happening there. And that was done through the multi-state. We can also specify that when the data is bad, we can force this to blink as well. And that's an option that's available for all of these. So for example, I think I'll have it blink when it's bad and blink when it's too high. There we go. So state 3 should blink this for me. I'll do that for that. I can also do this over here for this as well. We'll go with blink for that. So the big finish to this would be, let's see what happens when we go above 80. Let me scroll in so that we can do this a little better. And there we go. So going above 80, we now see that this is blinking, getting our attention. We'll conclude this by showing you how to remove all this. If I go into the multi-state definition, this convert to static simply converts this back to the way it was before.